Good morning, students. In last class, we discussed about the different types of feedbacks. In that, we discussed the positive feedback and negative feedback. Positive feedback occur when feedback signal is in phase with the input signal. And negative feedback occur if the feedback signal is out of phase with the input signal. Yes. So, we prefer the negative feedback in the amplifiers because it increases the bandwidth and decreases the distortion noise. Yes. So now we'll see the how the negative feedback affects on the characteristics of amplifiers like gain, bandwidth, input resistance, output resistance, etc. Yes. This is the signal flow diagram of feedback amplifier. Yes. Here, the quantity X is nothing but a voltage or current signal. S, here XF is the feedback signal and XI is the input signal. S, these two are out of phase. S, then this kind of feedback is called negative feedback. S, so here this is indicates the mixer network. S, the mixer network is used to mixing of a part of output signal to the input signal. This one is feedback network. This feedback signal is proportional to the output signal. Yes. So here feedback network gain is, we are considering it is a beta, then we can write feedback signal XF equals to beta into X0. So in negative feedback, this XS and XF, yes, source signal and feedback signal are out of phase by 180 degrees. Yes, then we can write in negative feedback XS and XF are out of phase by 180 degrees. Yes, therefore we can write XI equals to XS minus XF. Yes. Next, here this mixing is used to combine the feedback signal and input signal. Yes, so we can write mixer refers to mixing a part of output signal with input signal. Yes, here this feedback signal XF is proportional to the output signal. Yes or no? So we can write this feedback signal is proportional to the output signal. Yes. So we can write XF is directly proportional to the X0. Then we can write it is equals to beta into X0. Yes. Here beta is feedback factor. Now we'll see how it affects on the gain. Yes. First, we'll see the effect on gain. Here, the basic amplifier is converted into the feedback amplifier by adding the additional feedback network. Yes. So, this feedback network contains the two-port passive network. Yes. That means it contains only passive elements. Yes. And this feedback network consists of resistor in negative feedback and RLC will also used in the positive feedback. So this feedback, basic feedback amplifier is converted into the feedback amplifier by adding the feedback network in the circuit. Yes, and this feedback network consists only passive elements, or that may be resistive, capacitive, inductors. Yes, when you are using only resistive components here in the feedback network, then it becomes the negative feedback. When you are using the RLC in the feedback network, then it becomes the positive feedback. Yes, so we can write this basic amplifier is converted into feedback amplifier by connecting an additional network called feedback network. Yes. This feedback network is a two-port passive network and consists passive elements only. Feedback network consists of resistors in negative feedback and combination of RLC in positive feedback. So in negative feedback we'll use only resistive components. In positive feedback it's a combination of RLC components. Yes, ultimately the feedback network contains only passive elements. Yes, then we can write the basic amplifier gain, or we can say it is an open loop gain, A equals to basic amplifier gain, otherwise you can say it is open loop gain. Why? Because there is no feedback. Basic amplifier is nothing but which does not have any feedback. So it is equals to A equals to R A O L equals to X naught by XA. Yes, output quantity by input quantity, that is a voltage or current quantity. Yes, this X naught by XS is the gain of feedback amplifier, or it is closed loop gain. Yes, so we can represent it is equals to AF, or it is equals to ACL. Yes, we can write it is equals to X naught by XS. So this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. As we know, the gain of feedback network is beta, which is written as XF by X naught. Here I am naming as equation number 3. As in negative feedback, we know we can write XA equals to XS minus XF. As from this we can write XS equals to XI plus XF. Since XF equals to beta into X naught, by replacing here we can write XS equals to XI plus beta into X naught. Yes, so we can write XS equals to XI plus beta. X naught equals to what we can write? From this X naught equals to here, we can write x naught equals to A into XI. A equals to x naught by XI. From this we can write x naught equals to A into XI. Yes. So from this we can write XS equals to XI is common. Then you can write it is equals to 1 plus A beta. This is equation number 4. Combine this equation number 4 and 2. Then we will get it is equals to from 2 and 4 we can write AF equals to, that means feedback amplifier gain equals to X naught by XS. This XS is replaced with X naught by XI into 1 plus A beta. Yes, we know X naught by XI is nothing but what we can write? We can write A only. So we can write it is equals to A by 1 plus A beta. Yes, from this we can write feedback amplifier gain or closed loop gain is equals to, we can write A by 1 plus A beta. Yes, so here A is the open loop gain, that is nothing but A is the gain of the basic amplifier. Yes, without feedback. After feedback we will get it is equals to open loop gain by 1 plus A beta times. So otherwise you can write it is A open loop by 1 plus beta A open loop. From this, if 1 plus A beta term is greater than 1, then we can write AF is smaller compared to the open loop gain. Yes, therefore we can write, thus the negative feedback decreases the in gain. Due to the negative feedback, the resultant input XI becomes smaller, which causes the decrease in the output X naught. Hence, gain X naught by XS becomes decreases. As here we can write, as due to negative feedback, resultant input XI becomes smaller. Y plus is 2 are out of phase. Smaller, which cause decrease in output X naught. Hence, gain X naught by XS. That is what feedback amplifier gain X naught by XS decreases. Next, we'll see the loop gain. A loop gain is nothing but A beta. We already said, right? It is a factor by which a signal gets multiplied. Yes, when it passes through the feedback once. Yes, it is called return ratio. Otherwise, loop gain is nothing but product of A and beta, feedback network gain and basic amplifier gain. So loop gain is equals to A beta. So here loop gain is minus A beta for the negative feedback and positive A beta for positive feedback. Amount of feedback is expressed in dBs. We'll write here note. The amount of feedback is extracted from the output to the feedback network. Yes. So amount of feedback is expressed in dB, in dB decibels, and it is calculated from 20 log AF by A only. Yes. So you can say it is amount of feedback. We can write 20 log AF equals to, we can write it is equals to A by 1 plus A beta. By substituting here, you will get here it is equals to 1 by 1 plus A beta. Yes. So we can write it is equals to minus 20 log 1 plus A beta. Yes. The amount of feedback is negative in the feedback amplifier. Yes. Therefore, the amount of feedback is negative in negative feedback amplifiers and it is positive in positive feedback. Yes, here gain is decreased by 1 plus A beta times AF equals to A by 1 plus A beta. Yes, so this negative feedback decreases the feedback gain 1 plus 1 by 1 plus A beta times. Yes, next we will see the how this negative feedback effect on cutoff frequencies. That may be 3 dB cutoff, 3 dB low cutoff frequency and upper cutoff frequencies. So next we'll see the effect on cutoff frequencies. Here I'm not deriving the how cutoff frequency of feedback amplifier. Here I'm writing directly. This negative feedback decreases the lower cutoff frequency and it increases the upper cutoff frequency. Yes, here I'm giving directly. Lower cutoff frequency of feedback amplifier is FL by 1 plus A beta. That means FL is the lower cutoff frequency of without feedback. Yes. FLF is the lower cutoff frequency of with feedback. Yes. So we can say that lower cutoff frequency is reduced by 1 by 1 plus A beta times. Yes. And we can write upper cutoff frequency FHF equals to FH into 1 plus A beta. Yes. FH is the upper cutoff frequency of without feedback. Yes. FHF is the upper cutoff frequency of with feedback amplifier. Yes. So this upper cutoff frequency is increased by 1 plus A beta times. And this low cutoff frequency is decreased by 1 plus A beta dash. Yes. Then, does the negative feedback increases the bandwidth? Yes or no? Bandwidth is nothing but the difference between the upper cutoff frequency and the lower cutoff frequency. Yes, a lower cutoff frequency is decreases, upper cutoff frequency is increases, then the negative feedback increases the bandwidth. Yes, we can write it is equals to bandwidth with feedback is equals to bandwidth into 1 plus A beta times. Yes, so it improves the bandwidth 1 plus A beta times. Yes, then we can write product of gain and bandwidth remains constant with feedback and without feedback. Without feedback. There is no change in the product of the gain bandwidth with feedback and without feedback. Why? Because, say, I'm writing here it is equal to AF into bandwidth F. Here A into bandwidth. So, in the without feedback amplifier, here the gain is more, bandwidth is small. Here, in the feedback amplifier, gain is small, bandwidth is more. The product of this gain and bandwidth is constant in the both the amplifiers, with and without feedback amplifiers. Yes, so here you can observe the frequency response. Here, you are writing A, this is frequency F. So, when there is no feedback, we will get the more gain. It is without feedback. Yes. So, when there is feedback, we'll get the low gain but high bandwidth. This with feedback. Yes. This gain is AVF. This gain is AV. Yes. Otherwise, you can say it is A. Yes. This is FL and FH. This one is FLF. And this one is FHF. Yes. So here, low cutoff frequency is decreases and upper cutoff frequency is increases. The bandwidth also increases. Why? Because the difference between upper cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency is also increases. It is nothing but bandwidth. Yes. But the product of gain and bandwidth remains constant with and without feedback. Next, we will see the effect of stability of gain. As we said, this negative feedback offers the more stability in the gain. Yes. So we know the negative feedback increases stability of gain, or it makes the gain more stable. More stable. Yes, we'll see. As we know, AF equals to A by 1 plus A beta. Yes. Differentiate this one with respect to A, then we can write DAF by DA, it is equals to, yes, now we can apply U by V, yes, we can write 1 plus A beta into DA by A 1 minus A into 1 plus A beta, here beta by 1 plus A beta all square, yes. So here we can write this A beta cancel, we'll get it is equals to DAF by DA equals to 1 by 1 plus A beta all square. Yes. So here I am multiplying and dividing with A. Yes. Then we can write DAF by DA equals to, I can write it is equals to A by 1 plus A beta as 1 term. And 1 by A as one term, and 1 by 1 plus A beta is another term. S square is divided into 1 plus A beta into 1 plus A beta. I am writing in this way. S. So here we can write this DAF by DA equals to A by 1 plus A beta into 1 by A. S. into 1 plus A beta. Yes. So we can replace this term with the AF. Yes or no? So then we can write DAF by DA equals to AF by A S into 1 by A plus 1 plus A beta S. So here we can write DAF by AF equals to 1 by 1 plus A beta into DA by A. If 1 plus A beta is greater than 1, then we can write DAF by AF term is less than the DA by A. S. So you can say here the change in the feedback amplifier is smaller to the change in the basic amplifier gain. S. So from this we can write if the gain of basic amplifier changes by large amount, then gain of feedback amplifier changes by small amount. Yes. So the gain of the basic amplifier changes by large, then gain of the feedback amplifier changes small. As from this we can write. Yes. Here we need to define the term as sensitivity. Yes. So sensitivity is defined as it is a ratio of relative change in the gain of feedback amplifier and basic amplifier. So we can write it is the ratio of relative change in gain of feedback amplifier and basic amplifier. Yes. So we can write S equals to DAF by AF by DA by A. Yes. So it is the sensitivity of the amplifier. Yes. So from this we can write DAF by AF, DA by A. Its ratio equals, we can write it is equals to 1 by 1 plus A beta. Yes. So S equals to 1 by 1 plus A beta. Yes. The smaller S indicates the better stability in gain. Yes. So here smaller S. S indicates the better stability. Yes. When sensitivity is very small, then the stability in gain is more as good. Yes. Similarly, here we can write desensitivity. It is reciprocal of sensitivity. It is reciprocal of sensitivity. Yes. So we can write D equals to 1 by S. It is equals to 1 plus A beta. The term 1 plus A beta is nothing but desensitivity. Yes. It is a measure of ability of negative feedback to desensitize or you can say stabilize the gain. Yes. This greater desensitivity is reciprocal of the sensitivity. So when sensitivity is smaller, then stability is more. So here when desensitivity is larger, then stability is more in gain. So we can write greater desensitivity indicates better stability in gain. As when desensitivity increases, gain reduces but becomes more stable. As when desensitivity increases, gain reduces but gain becomes more stable. Yes. We said AF equals to A by 1 plus A beta. It is nothing but A by D only, na? Desensitivity. Yes. When desensitivity increases, that gain is decreases but stability in gain is more. Yes. So we can write AF equals to A by 1 plus A beta. It is equals to A by D. Yes. Next, effect on frequency distortion. It's a negative feedback decreases the frequency distortion. Yes. How I am saying this one? So we know the frequency response, the gain and voltage gain here, the bandwidth is increases. Yes, that means in negative feedback, the voltage gain is constant, remains over a long range of frequencies. So from this we can say this frequency distortion is very small or it is neglected. So when negative feedback is used, gain remains constant over a large range of frequencies. Yes. So in this way we can say effect on frequency distortion, it decreases the frequency distortion. Yes. Next we will see effect on input resistance. Yes. So here you can write feedback voltage VF opposes the VS. Yes. The input current II becomes less. Yes. And input resistance with feedback can be written as RIF equals to, we can write VS by II. Yes. When II is small, then RF will be increases. So this RF is greater than the RI value. Yes. So in voltage series and current series feedback RIF equals to RI into 1 plus A beta. Yes. But in voltage shunt and current shunt, RIF equals to RI by 1 plus A beta. So in shunt mixing, that input resistance is decreases. In series mixing, input resistance is increases. Yes. So this is the effect on the input resistance. Next we will see the effect on output resistance. Yes. So that input resistance is depends on the how we are mixing. Yes. How we are mixing the signal in series or manner. In series or shunt manner. Yes. In series manner, it increases the input resistance without depending on the what is the sample. That may be voltage or current. Yes. But here the output resistance is depends on the type of sample. Yes. If sample is voltage, that may be voltage series or voltage shunt, the output resistance of feedback amplifier equals to R0 by 1 plus A beta or R0 by D. Yes. So it is for voltage series and voltage shunt. Yes. If sample is current, then output resistance of feedback amplifier equals to R0 into 1 plus A beta. Here it is multiples of D times. Yes. For the current series and current shunt. Yes. So the output resistance is depends on the sample type. Depends on sample type. And input resistance is depends on the mixing type. Yes. These are the different parameters affected by the our negative feedback. Yes. Thank you.